Hey everybody, it's Ileane from Basic Blog Tips. In this video, I want to talk to you about images and an application you can use with Google Chrome called PicMonkey. PicMonkey's a neat little application that lets you touch up photos and make collages and do all kinds of editing, adding text to your videos, and just go right over to the Chrome store and upload it, and it will be an application on your browser. But stay tuned because I'm also going to show you how to integrate it with Google Drive. Once you install the application, you'll find it on your desktop when you open up a blank tab. Now, it's a free application, but you can also pay to get the upgrades, and the upgrades give you some additional functionality. But we're just going to take a look at the free version. So here you would just click to open or drag a photo right there. Now, when you open up the image, of course, you'll have all your basic functions, just like you would with any other editing software. You can crop or you can rotate. But I wanted to show you a couple of tricks that I use. I like to use this section called Frames. This is one of my favorites. It's Simple Edge. But what I do is I normally will get rid of the extra edge there. Then I'll turn the thickness to match the image. So in this case, I'm going to make it white. But you notice you have the eyedropper tool there. So you really can pick any color you want from within the image. But I'm going to keep it white. And what I like here is that you can add a caption, which makes the border at the bottom of the image bigger. Then you can go into the text tool and pick your text. And they have lots of free fonts here. You'll notice anytime you see this little crown, that means that it's one of the paid tools. So you have to pay for those. But let's just use one of the free ones. So you select the font, then you pick add text. Then you can also change the color. Okay, this time let's use a nice purple color. And then you can align the text how you want, center it. I chose this, let's give them something to talk about. I know, I got to work on my singing. But there's a few other options here you can check out. You can add some type of emoticons. And, you know, there's just all kinds of things. You could spend all day just looking through all the things that you can do with images. Then when you're all done, of course, you just save your image, and it gives you a choice of the quality that you want to save it at, and it lets you know what your dimensions are and the size of the file that you're going to be saving. So if you, they use the 007 thing here, and if you want Roger, Pierce, or Sean quality of your images, of course, if you pick Sean, you're going to get a much higher quality image. But let me do as promised and show you how to integrate PicMonkey with Google Drive. So now let's just close this out. Now over in Google Drive, I've already uploaded that same image. And I have to give a shout out to the Google guru. He's the one who taught me this little tip here. When you just choose the item that you want to open, in this case, we're going to do image, go over here to more and then open with. And in this case, we're going to choose PicMonkey. Now, when you make all of your edits to your image and you save it, let's just do something with colors here. Change the temperature. It's going to save the image that you have and drive. So you don't have to download it back to your computer. It will be in Google Drive. Let's go back over to Google Drive and take a look. See, there's that alteration that I made of the color. This will also come in handy because you're not altering your original image. You still have that on your computer, but you're altering the one. Maybe you want to use this in a presentation. You're making slideshare presentations, or you can use it for Google Docs. Whatever you want to do, it's in the cloud, and you still have your original intact saved on your computer. So, in order to connect any applications with Google Drive, you would just go over here to Open With, and at the bottom it says Connect More Apps. Then you will go through the apps that are available for connection with Google Drive. And just look for PicMonkey. But of course, there's a bunch of other ones here that you can check out. One last option is you can just download this image directly from Drive back onto your computer. You might want to change the name or save it in a different folder. So there you go, guys. Check out the PicMonkey app for Google Chrome and have some fun. You can use those images for Pinterest, of course, and Facebook posting, and Google Plus likes images as well. So get started with PicMonkey. Thanks for joining me today. And while you're on YouTube, subscribe to my channel. Connect with me on my blog, which is basicblogtips.com. And you can also follow my podcast, and that's the Miss Ileane Speaks podcast. I'll talk to you soon. Thanks so much for joining me, and have a great day. Peace.